chilling in the streets. Yeah, I just kind of wanted to update you a little bit about what's going on. People here are still really amazing, and I'm really thankful for them. This past week has been kind of a little bit harder, as you can tell by my email. But that's kind of why I wanted to write it out and not really FaceTime it, because I was like, I don't want to be so, like, negative or talk about all the things I'm struggling with. But if you could pray for me and just to spend more quality time with Jesus, that would be awesome. And that kind of segues into why I labeled my email Living Distracted. A lot of times, God has been convicting me that I'm choosing to go play soccer, choosing to go play basketball, choosing to do all these, go to the beach, go swimming, all these things that I'm choosing before I choose to spend time with Him, one-on-one, and just have this, like, personal relationship with Him. But it's a process, and I'm learning that it doesn't just happen overnight, and that it takes a little bit. But yeah, the people here are so amazing, and they're so sweet, and it's exciting to have everyone else's, like, everyone gets new revelations every day, or like when they're praying and they're like, Jesus spoke to me. Like, it's just really exciting just to see the things that God has been doing. Yeah, I mean, there's not like a whole lot of new things going on. It's still like class every day, work duties every day, meals, you know, things like that. But once in a while, do some homework. Like that. It's just, it's really good, and it's really eye-opening to really dig deep and try to figure out why I believe what I believe, and yeah, so it's been really good. It's kind of funny, because I really want to learn Spanish, so we went to church yesterday, to an all-Spanish-speaking church, and so it was good. Like, I'm going to learn. They better just speak to me all the time. Like, it's good. So then we went to lunch afterwards with three guys, me and my friend Michaela, and then three other guys, and they speak a little bit of English, but they mostly speak Spanish. And we speak a little bit of Spanish, but mostly English. And we're at the table, and we're trying to order, and I'm, like, trying to be like, okay, I need to let people know that, like, I cannot have any kind of nuts in my salad, like almonds, pecans, cashews, peanuts, like anything. I cannot have it. And I was, like, trying to explain this to them, and they, like, didn't know the words or what I was talking about. So I'm, like, using their phone to, like, Google Translate. Like, we're trying to, like, communicate here. Our waitress is like, what are you doing? Because she doesn't know English either. So they get a waitress over that, like, knows English. She starts talking to us, and she, like, helps us out. We're all good. Okay, awesome. And then she comes back and she goes, I just have to ask, are you guys on a date? Like, oh, my word, there's three boys and two girls. Like, why would we be on a date? Anyway. And I'm like, no, like, totally no. Like, I laugh. I'm like, there's no way. She goes, okay, good, because that would be really awkward. I'm like, okay. So that's just, like, a slight glimpse of the experiences here with the Spanish language. Sorry, I just got cut off because someone came up to me, so I just had to say goodbye. This is my friend Dan.
Hi. Bye.
Bye. So, thank you, guys, and bye.